In this vlog, we are going to deal with the implementation of an API request using which we are going to download a file. So till now we have done API request for CRUD operations making use of a Dio library. So we have performed get, post, put, delete, update. So all these API requests we have seen in our previous tutorials using Dio library, and in this part of the tutorial we are going to download a text file with the help of an API request. So if you are watching this tutorial for the first time, I suggest you to go through our previous tutorials on Dio library implementation in Flutter application, so that you will be getting a basic knowledge on how we implement a network call in our Flutter applications using Dio library. So now let's get started with this particular tutorial. So the very first thing I would like to change here is, like, we are making use of the previous tutorial's code, so we'll be just trying to edit this particular getData method to download our file. So the very first thing is, let's change it to download file, and then the method name also I'm going to change it to download file. And you need to appropriately change this even here, so that whenever we tap on the button, we are able to call this particular method and our download API request is being called. So we have initialized Dio library here and created an object so that we can make use of the, so we can specify our API request. And as we are going to download a file here, so we need to specify the exact path and location where we want to download our file, and for which let us try to make use of a directory here and create an object for it, so that we can get the absolute path where we want to download our text file. So add await here, so that we need to find the location and try to save it in this particular object, and later we can use it. So application document directory. So now we are going to fetch the location and trying to use it to save our text file. And here, instead of get here, we are having multiple options now. So do dot, we have got multiple options like delete, download, and fetch, get. These things we have seen in our previous tutorial. So now we are going to use download here, and the download API request will accept. So the download API request will accept two inputs here. So the first input is the API link here. So the link for our file, we need to specify it over here, and this is the link I am providing now. So from filesamples.com we are going to download this sample1.txt file. And now the second thing we need to specify here is the place where we want to store this. So this is also an important step. Now you need to specify the exact location where you want to download the file. Just try to carefully observe this and how I am going to provide the location. So we are going to make use of the directory here. We need to make use of the directory here. So I am specifying directory.path, and we need to also provide the name here. So the file name also we need to provide here. What is the name of the file using which we are going to store the, what is the name of the file by using which we are going to store it. So I'm just trying to specify file.txt here, and if you observe here in the URL, we have got the name to be sample1.txt, but now we are storing it on our device with the name called file.txt, but the data inside the file will be same. Just we are trying to provide the name according to our application requirement, that's all. There is no change in the file name. You can just specify any name here according to your requirement. And now let's try to run this particular code and see the output once. And also one more thing I would like to specify here is, like, we are downloading the file here and we need to get the user permission to write user permission in terms of write permissions. So I have dealt clearly the implementation of runtime permissions in this particular tutorial. So I suggest you to go through this particular tutorial, and if you are still having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below, like how we have implemented the runtime permissions. So then I would surely help you with it. And now here, let's try to tap on the download file button and try to observe the console, like what the thing is going on. So here you can see we have got the response.status code as 200. So if you have gone through our previous tutorials, you might be well aware like what is the status code, and if it is 200, then it indicates that this API call is success. And now let's try to see where our file is being downloaded. So for which, let's go to the device file explorer here, and here you can see we have got file.txt file under our package name here. So when you tap on this particular file, you can see like we have got the same file loaded. And now for your observation, let's try to rename this particular file to file2.txt, and now let's try to run this particular code and see the output once. And when we tap on download file button here, we again got status code 200, that is our API call is success. But now here you can see our file is not being displayed here, and still it is showing file.txt. So this might be a confusion for the beginners, but don't get confused in this particular step here. Just try to refresh your emulator and try to go through the data folder again, and inside the data folder there is again a data folder, and from there you need to choose your package name here. So my package name is like com.example.flutter_dio here. So here inside which, in app_flutter folder, we are storing our file. And now here clearly you can see our file2.txt is also being downloaded here. So don't get confused when you don't see your file there. Just try to refresh the device file explorer, then surely you can see the downloaded file again. And if you are having any queries regarding the path of this particular folder where you are trying to store the data, I suggest you to just try to print the directory.path here. So just try to print this directory.path with the help of a print statement, and you will surely get to know the exact path in the console where you are trying to store your file here. And this file name also you can just dynamically take from the user by just specifying an input label here. So in our previous tutorials, you can just try to see here how we have provided an input label and try to accept the user information. So in that way, you can just generate the file name here. And also you can just auto generate the file names by making use of any other random scenarios. So yes, this is it for this tutorial. And regarding the permissions, I suggest you to go through this particular tutorial on how to seek the runtime permission. And if you are having still query, just let me know in the comment section below. I will surely try to help you. And this is it for this tutorial on download API request implementation using Dio library in your Flutter application. And the code for this tutorial is provided in the description section below. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.